Hello everybody, I'm Dallin Christensen from Whiteboard Business Partners. This is another edition of At the Whiteboard. I'm probably one of the few people that hasn't weighed in on the iPhone 5 situation yet, but I hold in my hands an iPhone 4S. It's a little bit longer and a little bit lighter, but you know that the iPhone 5 does have a very similar look and feel to the iPhone 4S. And for a lot of people, this is a bad thing. There are plenty of people on the web saying that Apple needs to update its design in order to catch up with competitors like Samsung or Motorola. To that I say, why would Apple want to change what has been an iconic design? If you have a design that is as much a part of your branding and your marketing as your logo itself, why change? I'm a big sports fan. And when I think of sports and I think of iconic logos, I think of the Dallas Cowboys star. I think of the Nike swoosh. I think of the G on the Green Bay Packers helmets. Those are iconic symbols that the world knows. Why change them? Why change something that is simply changing for the sake of change? This is a design that's known all throughout the world. People instantly see a phone like this and they know it's an iPhone. It's a part of Apple's identity. It's a part of their heritage. Why would Apple want to change something that is such a part of their fabric simply for changing something? The key point to remember in all of this is that if you have something that has become a key part of your identity, hold on to it. Make it a part of your culture. Make it a part of your branding. Communicate that idea, that design, that key item that makes you unique and remarkable. For more tips and tools on how to help you grow your business, visit www.whiteboardbusiness.com. I'm Dallin Christensen for Whiteboard Business Partners. I'm here to help you make your business happen.